All right. What's going on, everybody? Welcome to the pre-show. Yes. Very excited about tonight. Super, super excited, in fact. Very special guest. I actually haven't had a guest on with an in-depth interview in a little while, as some of you know. So we're doing it tonight. Look at my hat. Oh, yeah. All right, let me check in with everybody. The hat matches my dress code and my mug. Yeah. That's right, all things talk box tonight. By the end of the night, you're gonna know everything. Right. All right, where's everybody at? Where's everybody at? Hello, hello, hello. Yeah, all right. We got Washington, Maryland, the Big Island, aloha. We got Rhonda in Northern California, Kenya. It went too fast. Tampa Bay in the house. Hey, Judy. Crystal and, yes, good evening. Hope in New York. Sue in, Honolulu. Casey and Dorothy, what up? Sasha in Munich, Germany. Hey. Who else is here? Nedra in Northern California. Janet. Waiting for your merchandise to show up. Email Jesse. Everybody else got theirs. I don't know what's going on. All right, Daryl. In Philadelphia. You're eating a Philly cheesesteak, eh? We got New Orleans in the house. Nolens. South Carolina says hello. Hi, Janet. Linda in Lansing, Michigan. Fort Walton Beach, Florida. Hey, Fran. Yeah. Houston, Texas is in the house. I know a lot of people from Texas here. All right. Yeah, welcome. How's Texas right now? Is it warm? Because it's like 10 degrees up in Chicago. I'm not lying. Yeah, it turned. The polar winds came down. They got us. Yesterday, it was not bad. It's like almost like 40. Anyway, hey, it's January. What are you going to do? What are you going to do? Marcus Howery, how are you? What's up, man? Cecil Ramirez is in the house. Hello. Sharon Bradley in Seattle. Uh-huh. Debbie's in the house. Caprice, what up? Yeah. Oh, more people from Philly. Hey, hey, hey. Dee Dee in Fort Washington, Maryland. Okay, hi. Burlington, New Jersey. Belinda, hi. LaRonda in Los Angeles, in sunny, hot Los Angeles. I heard it was super cold there right now, like 57. Oh, man. It's crazy. I'm going to let this song jam out. We got a few minutes. This is the pre-show. Welcome to the pre-show. Mr. Talkbox is my special guest tonight. Currently, he's viewing a new documentary that was released today as part of the virtual NAMM show. Yamaha Entertainment put it together, I believe. It's called The Sound of Us. So hopefully it'll be available, you know, after today. They were just debuting it today on the virtual NAMM show, which is going on this week. So Mr. Talkbox is in the documentary. So now you know. The Sound of Us. Yeah. All right. Who else is here? Wow. Some Beach, Florida. I can't read that whole. Hallandale, Florida. Stay with it.
Stay with it.
Yeah, hi. DFW. All right. Dallas, Fort Worth. Hi. Oceanside, California. Doris, how you doing? Chocolate Jazz Radio from West Virginia is here. Chocolate Jazz Radio. Do you eat chocolate while you're broadcasting? Is that what it's all about? What do you guys do over there? I need to know these things. All right. Colorado Springs, Dave and Karen. Hey. Yeah. All right. We got 2 minutes. We're almost there. The song is getting to the end. You can tell. You can tell. It's feeling good. That's right. Mr. Talkbox is here. All things Talkbox tonight. You're going to know everything you will ever need to know about the Talkbox after tonight's program. So, you know, stay with me for the duration. We got a lot of stuff. We're jamming. Things, this and that. It's all good. All right. You know, I think I'm slightly early. This song is about to end. Wow. That song is in, and I still need to talk to you for 1 minute because I am 1 minute early to the top of the hour. But that's cool. That's cool. I'll just be me and you right here. I know I'm in your living room or wherever you're watching right now. Hello. Thanks for tuning in. This is, disclaimer, this is still the pre-show. I just started at 1 minute early. My bad.
Stay with.
Yeah, I already got two stay with it moments already in the program, and we haven't even really started. The show's about to start in about 10 seconds. Ready? Here. All right, let me get it together. Let me get it together. Yeah, it's January 22 in the year 2021. Hello. All right, here we go. Are you ready? Bam. Hey, it's Brian Culbertson. We're live, and it's Friday night. Oh! What's up, everybody? Welcome to the hang. Oh, we be jamming tonight. Ready?
It's Friday night.
I got my, you know.
It's Friday night.
I got some sunshine.
It's Friday night. It's Friday night.
Oh, man. That's right, it is. What? All right, everybody. Tonight, I got a very special guest. My man, Byron Talkbox Chambers. That's Mr. Talkbox to you. Oh, yeah. It's on. What?
It's Friday night.
It's Friday night.
It's Friday night.
Oh, yeah.
It's Friday night.
No,
it's Friday night.
Even my wine matches. Bam! All right. That was a lot of stuff going on right there. Welcome to the hang. Cheers to you, whatever you're getting into. I need some background music. Hello. So, what am I drinking? Let me just get right to it. So, in honor of Mr. Talkbox being here tonight, I asked him, he's like, okay, man, what's your favorite adult beverage? And he's like, dude, Moscato. I'm like, all right, I got you. So, I went through my wine fridge. I was like, where's my Moscato? And I don't have any. So, next best thing. All right, I got a sweet sparkling from our friends at the castle. Check this out, this is so good. Oh yes, La Fantasia, yes. Oh, have you had this? It's really, really, wow. It's like a burst of, it's like, remember, what were those things? Like, Starburst can? It's like putting a Starburst in your mouth. The adult version. Hey, let's get a sip, shall we? Damn, that's pretty good. It's just fun. It's fun. So that's what I'm drinking tonight. Sure, you got something, you know, cooking at your house too. So anyway, tonight, like I said, is about the talk box. So I'm going to do songs of mine that actually feature the talk box. Did you know I have actually three songs in my repertoire prior to this year that actually have talk box on it? So I'm going to start with one. We're going to go back to the Come On Up album. Remember that? I need another sip. Dang, this is good. Going back to the Come On Up CD, I did a cover of an Earth, Wind, and Fire song. And this is actually the track that made it possible for me to meet up with Maurice White in the first place. Is amazing. I'll tell you the story after the track. So this is it. Serpentine Fire. Oh, yes. I made it. Serpentine Fire. You know, that was a track. We actually put that out as a radio single. It started getting played on The Wave in Los Angeles. Maurice White's engineer at the time heard it on the radio, actually went to Best Buy and bought the CD. Remember those days? Yeah. And he went back to the studio, played it for everybody. I think the next week I got a call. So pretty cool, pretty cool. Anyway, so tonight, like I said, is all about the talk box. And before we get into this, I asked a lot of the Hand Club members, is like, do you have any questions? And so many of them said, what is it? So that leads me to this.
Fun facts from the internet. Fun facts from the internet.
Ow. That's right. I'm going to start with this. I'm going to get right into it. What is a talk box and when was it invented in the whole nine? Well, first of all, you've heard it on so many recordings like Bon Jovi's Living on a Prayer, Peter Frampton's Do You Feel Like We Do, Joe Walsh's Rocky Mountain Way, you know, those are going way back, and Stevie Wonder's album, Music of My Mind, and of course, Roger Troutman and Zapp. I mean, More Bounce to the Ounce. That's a funk anthem. And then the 90s, Tupac, California Love. Oh, yeah. I mean, yeah, we all know the talk box, right? But what is it? Where did it come from? Well, according to the internet, the talk box was originally invented in the 1930s for military purposes. It's classified, though. Right. Well, it was first used for music in 1939. So in 39, Alvino Ray, who was an amateur radio operator, used a carbon throat microphone wired in such a way as to modulate his electric steel guitar sound. That microphone originally, you know, developed for, it was for military pilot communications, by the way. Who knows how that worked? Was placed on the throat of Ray's wife, Louise King, one of the King's sisters, you know, from 1939, who then stood behind a curtain and mouthed the words along with guitar lines that he played. The novel sounding combination was called singing guitar, and it employed on stage and in the movie Jam Session as a novelty attraction. I actually put a clip of it, of that movie, in the description. So after the show, you can click on that. There's a YouTube clip. You can see the very first time a talk box has been used on screen. So now you know. Anyway, it went on to develop, and it started being used in you know, rock and roll in the 70s, and of course funk music. But enough of that. I'm gonna let Mr. Talkbox tell you more in just a minute. Before we get to the first part of the interview, though, I got to play one more tune that I have Talkbox. And this one comes from my Bringing Back the Funk record. It's in there subtly. So if you get your headphones on, you will hear it over to the left side a little bit. There's Talkbox over to the left side. This is You Got to Funkify's featuring Chance Howard with some Talkbox laced up underneath it. You'll hear it. Uh-huh. Oh, yeah. Here we go. Oops. I'm supposed to play now.
Stay with
How low can you go? You got to funkifies. Oh, man. Chance Howard on there. Did you hear the talk box in there? Well, let's get to it. I sat down with my friend, Mr. Talkbox. Here's part one of our interview. Mm-hmm. Four-time Grammy Award winner, two-time Dove Award winner. You did the intro to 24K Magic by Bruno Mars. I would say the most preeminent talkbox artist in the world today, Mr. Talkbox. What's up, man?
What's up, BC? What's going on with you, man?
Man, I am wonderful. I'm so happy you're here on the show with us today. I mean, we've been talking about this for months now.
Yes, it's long overdue. Thank you for having me.
Because you have a new album out that came out in the fall called Playlist.
Yes.
And man, it is so hot. It's unbelievable, man. I put it on and you can't stop bouncing to this one. I'm telling you, man. It's like, it's hip hop, it's pop, it's R&B, it's funk. It's like all of your influence. It's a gumbo of Talkbox.
Yes, gumbo of Talkbox. I like that. Oh, we got to use that.
But I love this record. So, yeah, I want to talk about it more later. But
yeah,
one thing I want to clear up initially. For those people out there watching, let's clear this up. Can we talk about the difference between what a Talkbox is and what auto-tune is? Because so many people get it kind of confused. What you do is not what T-Pain does.
Exactly. Exactly.
Just saying.
It's two different things. It's completely different. And when someone comes up to me and say, oh, I love that auto-tune thing you're doing, I'm like... No, you're insulting me. It's so much more work to do the talk box, you know?
Yes. So let me ask you this. Would you say you play the talk box or do you consider the talk box like an instrument or an effect?
I consider it an instrument, a vocal instrument at that, because you have to use your larynx to make it sound clear and to form words. And so as it, you know, just like we're talking here, we have to use that throat and we have to breathe. If you want to do it good, if you want to do it great, these are the techniques that you have to do to play the talk box and to make it come to life. So it's the real deal.
There you go. So do you remember the first time you ever heard one, like on the radio, or do you remember this experience?
I remember the very moment. I'm from Orlando, Florida. I had to have been 13 years old. Okay. And my cousin and I, we were hanging out. We just finished playing basketball and we went to his house. We went over to his house. We was going to chill over there.
Yeah.
This guy pulls out this Roger Troutman record and he plays this song, Computer Love. And I'm like, what the heck is that? It blew me away. I never heard anything like it. And then I said, I got to hear more of this. So he pulls out another record. His mom had all of the Roger records, Roger and Zap. He had the maxi single of I Want to Be Your Man. And when I heard that song, that was the moment. It completely mesmerized me. I said, I'm doing that. I got to find that thing. And I gotta do it. And you know, at the time, you know, I grew up in the church, man. So I was doing gospel music. So I'm like, I'm gonna be the first guy to do that in gospel music. And I did it. I went on that journey to find it and I started doing it in gospel music. And that's where I got my training. And here we are, man.
So let's back up a little bit. When did you like formally start playing an instrument? I read you play actually five instruments, right?
Yes, absolutely.
So was it in the church or was it in your house or how did that start for you?
It started in our house because my mom and dad, they had a gospel quartet group. Now listen, there's a difference here. Most people, when you say quartet, you're thinking of, you know, maybe four or five people in a band. But this was an actual genre. It's like a Chitlin Circuit type genre. That's it.
Yeah. I know.
And so I started, my parents and their group, they used to rehearse at our apartment. And so we my brother and I, we're in the room. We were just like, oh man, we're excited. They're singing, and we were just back there. And they bought me a Muppet drum set from the Muppets with Animal's face plastered on the front of it.
I can envision that.
Yes.
That's hilarious.
Yes. So the drummer didn't show up one rehearsal.
Uh-oh.
And my parents didn't know that every week I'm listening and I'm learning. Now at the time, I'm 6 years old.
Okay.
I pulled that drum set out there and they were practicing and I started playing. And from that moment on, my parents were like,
what?
That's our drummer right there. He's going to be the drummer. So that's where my journey started. I started on drums, and then my dad, he was a guitarist, but he started doing a whole lot of more lead singing. So I picked up the guitar. I was playing guitar. I played the bass. Like as members were transitioning out, I was the guy that jumped on those instruments.
Man, love these stories. Much more with Mr. Talkbox, the interview that is coming up in the show. But right now, I want to play something because a couple weeks ago, I got to watch. He did a virtual world tour, hence the hat. Thanks for the hat. And it just blew me away. So I asked him if we could play one of the tracks, one of the tunes here. And this is from the latest album, the Playlist album. Here it is, Mr. Talkbox, Dance Break.
Are you feeling all right tonight? I said, are you feeling all right tonight? And I am. If you're feeling all right like me, I want you to do me one favor. I want you to get up out your seat right now. Yes, I see you get up out of your seat right now. Tonight, yeah.
Let's get back on the kind of the talk box and the way it works. I would love to have you kind of give a demonstration, because I would think most people don't know how it works mechanically.
I'm just gonna show you. It's really simple. So here we go.
Okay.
I'm gonna unplug it. It's a small box. That's why I think it's pretty easy.
Can you show it?
We have this. Yeah, absolutely. So we have this thing called the MXR talk box. This is the talk box that I've been using for the past, you know, since 2014. And I use the TalkStar. I use all kinds of talk boxes, so you know. Mm-hmm. But this one is a real simple one to explain. So you have this box.
Yeah.
Inside of this box, there's a small amplifier. Okay? There's a small amplifier, and this is a speaker. Okay, it's all housed inside of this. And then obviously you have your output, you know, you input your cable into this and you send that to the output of the sex machine, I call it, the DX100.
Oh.
And she's golden.
So you take a synthesizer, this little thing, and you plug that into there.
Yes.
So that when you play a note on there.
Yes. The sound will come through this speaker into this tube, which is really cool. You pop that tube in there. Mm-hmm. As you can see, it's pretty sealed. Yep. Sealed real tight, because you want all the sound to come through this tube. Dropping down to plug it back. I'm plugging the power source back up. This is so dope. I love doing this.
Yeah.
So you turn that baby on. That blue light is on.
Okay.
You turn your keyboard on. And then the magic begins. You hear that sound, okay? So all of that sound.
So that's you playing a note on the keyboard, and then it's coming amplified through this tube.
Yes.
Okay.
Exactly. So I'm doing that right there. And so now, back to what your question was about how you enunciate and make this thing come to life. So you have to take this tube.
Yeah.
You have to put it inside your mouth. And really the key is too, I don't know if you can see how that tube is kind of bitten down real good. See, that's worn out. But that's how you make the magic. You kind of bite it. You know, get right there in between there. Put it there. Yeah, you got to get It's like you got to get rough with it, man. And then the way I sound with this in my mouth, for instance, I'm going to say your name. It sounds like this. Brian Culberson. Okay? That's what I sound like. But I literally just Brian Culberson. And you have to over enunciate. You can't say Brian Culberson like that. You can't say it like that. You have to say Brian Culberson. Like instead of saying Culberson, I'd say Culberson. So it'll come out like Culberson. It's kind of weird symmetrics, but that's a lot of practice. But that's how you make this. When you put the tube in your mouth, you go, Brian Culberson. So you see what I'm saying? Brian Culberson, BC on the key. And so I'm playing the notes and I'm talking. So, you know, it's kind of like you sync it up. You know, you talk, you sync it up, and you sync it up with the notes and you feel it. And you have to, you should know how to sing and harmonize. That's another thing I loved about singing in quartet music. I sing backgrounds, I sing leads, I harmonize, and I understand all that stuff, you know, with the talk box. And I bring all of that mental space to the talk box to make it sound like a human being actually singing through the talk box.
Right.
So there it is.
That's fascinating, man.
Yeah, it's pretty cool, man. And it's been around since the 30s, man. This thing has been around since the 30s.
Okay.
And a lot of people say, oh, the auto-tune. Listen, auto-tune, they're trying to mimic the talk box in a much easier fashion, if that makes sense. You know what I'm saying?
Well, yeah, auto-tune is, for those watching out there, it's not an instrument, it's not hardware, it's a computer plug-in or software that will manipulate the voice after you've already sung like normal.
Yes.
Yeah, and then it
Big
can
difference.
Do that. A huge difference. Not, I mean, it's apples and oranges.
Yeah.
Now you know. Now you know. So thanks, man, for explaining. Now we know. We can all play it now. Right. Hey, I want to take a little moment and give some birthday shout-outs real quick. Should we do that? I think so. Mm-hmm. Oh! Yeah, we got some hand club members. Oh, the balloons are still here. Okay. We Marlene Jones is celebrating a birthday this week. Hey, Marlene. Ella Clark. Hey, what's up, Ella? Patricia Berry. Hi, Patricia. How you doing? We got Cheryl Lynn Holmes also celebrating a birthday. Those four are celebrating birthday. So cheers to you guys. Cheers, cheers, cheers. And if you're celebrating a birthday this week, happy birthday to you. Oh, yes. Uh-huh. Oh, we got an anniversary, too. Anniversary shout out. Let me get a sip. Uh-huh. We got to give a 9th anniversary, 9 years, to Bubba and Carrie Kyler. Happy anniversary, you guys. All right. Well, there it was. There it was. All right, I got another track with Talkbox in it. My David Bowie cover. This one's nasty. That was actually an outtake from the Bringing Back the Funk record. Did you, oh, it's crazy. It's crazy. Steve Lukather on guitar. Monty Newbel on the talk box there. Yeah, man. This was before I knew Mr. Talkbox. Well, hey, so check this out. Since Byron was so nice to explain how it actually works, maybe I should try it out myself. Should I do that? I didn't tell him. So earlier this week, I bought a Talkbox. Haven't even tried it. I mean, I plugged it up today, you know, just make sure it worked. So let me see if I've never done it. Ready? Should I do this? Okay. This is going to be really interesting. And probably horribly bad. No. Okay. Look at this. I got a tube. So he says, you got to bite down. You got to bite. Be rough. Okay, so I got a sound. Okay, I'm halfway there. I got a sound. I got the tube. I'm biting. Okay, here it goes. Okay, so I can do wah wah. That's all. That's okay. Let's see what else. Mr. Talk Box. No, that's no. I'm talking. You can't talk. So what do you do? Mr. Talk Box. Do you do that? Mr. Oh wait, I gotta play the keyboard.
Stay with.
This is unbelievably hard. How do you do this, man? All right. I guess I got to practice for 10 years.
Mr. Talkbox.
I don't know how they, I don't know. Okay. I'll do wah-wah.
Mr. Talkbox.
That's all I got. That's all I can do. I can't do a word. I don't know how you do that. That's crazy, man. All right. Hey, I got a couple questions. People are wondering. They're wondering, and I'm going to answer that before we get back to the next part of the interview. Okay, here's a couple questions. Reggie Turner is asking, is the Talkbox the same basic effect on a guitar as it is a keyboard? I believe so. So it works the same. So instead of playing a keyboard through it, you would just play a guitar. So there you go. Yolanda in New Jersey asks, what inspired you to collaborate with Mr. Talkbox on my 20 CD? Believe it or not, I was hanging out with Avery Sunshine recording for that album. And we were writing and recording More Than Thankful, right? And she's like, hey, what else are you working on? So I played her some of the tracks that I had going. And she's like, oh my God, you got to call Byron, our good friend Byron, because obviously Avery and Talkbox had worked together on some things. So she literally brought her phone out and called him up, and we ended up, you know, hooking up. And that's how that happened. So there you go. Thanks, Avery. One more little question here. Let's see. Somebody asked, oh yeah, I forgot to write who wrote this. But somebody asked, is it kind of gross? She's sitting there with a yuck face trying to find out how this thing. It's true. I mean, it's like in your mouth getting all spitty and stuff. Yeah. I don't know. You got to disinfect this sucker. Okay. It's awkward. And then it's like being at the dentist. You got a little drip. Mr. Talkbox, I'm sure you figured out how to not have like some wipes. No, I'm just messing around. All right. Yeah. And last question, Doug and Renee in Atlanta ask, how does one choose a Talkbox as a musical expression like on an album? I just think it comes down to like any production idea. You know, are you hearing that sound? So sometimes you are, sometimes you aren't. So just like vocals or a saxophone or anything else. So there it is. Should we get back to the interview? I think we should. Mr. Talkbox. Uh-huh. So I want to get into, you have a massive like YouTube following.
Man.
You started doing these covers and videos, multi-tracking yourself.
Yes.
Playing like all the parts, like 8, 10, 12 parts. And it's like, it's Brady Bunch style on the screen.
Yeah.
Like there's 12 of you. You're playing the bass, the keys, the lead over the top. I mean, what prompted you to want to start doing these?
Man, it's so, that's a great question. And yeah. You know, what really prompted me to start doing the acapella multi-screen videos was just, yeah. You know, my love for harmonies. I just love harmonies. And I never get to express those harmonies, you know, via recording, if you would, because it's always was mixed in with, you know, full band and sounds and all that stuff. So you don't get the true essence of what the talk box is and what, the, you know how it is. It's so much. Sometimes when we record, we have so much stuff in the foundation, yeah. That people, it don't make it to their ears.
Right,
so
right.
That's what kind of prompted me to say, I want to start doing these acapella videos. And then that app came out, the Pick Play Post app. When that app came out, it just lit me up.
Forget
and
it.
There you go.
So I have to ask, is that how you got connected with Bruno Mars through your YouTube channel? Or
yes.
Did that okay. I had a feeling.
Yeah, well, yeah. Well, I will say this. Having that YouTube channel and having those covers in place helped the situation, because what happened was his bass player, Jamario. Jamario, I used to play in a band called Toby Mac, and the bass player with Toby Mac and Jamario were good friends, and so so he used to come and check us out there. But he didn't realize, you know, I was in the band. You know, they didn't know, because I was just, you know, I was kind of playing like in the background. And then a song I did with Nathan East, which is called Daft Funk.
Jamario, I remember.
Yes. Jamario happens to be a big Nathan East fan. He hears the song. He reaches out to me via Twitter and says, dude, I got to do a song with you. This is crazy. And so from that moment, we developed a relationship. And that was back in 2014. So he and I had been talking for 2 years before I even got to 24 Karat. And he had been telling Bruno about me. So it's crazy. I released this video called I Want to Be Your Man, the Roger and Zap tribute.
Yeah.
That video went viral, like 2 million views. And Jamario started telling Bruno, you need to check this guy out, because he had already started working on 24 Karat. And so he was just looking for someone that was the best on the talk box. And so they started searching. They found me. And boom, the I Want to Be Your Man video was the video that sparked. He said, that's the guy.
All right, let's set this one up. I would love to hear or see the track that you did with Avery Sunshine. Can we do that one?
Oh, absolutely. And the song
is
called...
Can you tell us about the song real quick?
Yeah, and the song is actually called Sunshine, featuring Avery Sunshine.
Hello.
Beautiful love song.
Beautiful. Here it is, Sunshine. Mr. Talkbox and Avery Sunshine.
You're my sunshine. July, I am so high, you're my sunshine, yeah. I gotta say, everything about you feels right to me. Truly hope.
Wow. I love that track. That's a vibe. Man, I'm feeling that one. I'm feeling that one. Oh, man. So cool. Hey, we got one more little segment with our interview. Here it is. So we got to talk about the song that we did on my last record, the 20 album, track one, the number one single, actually, Get Up. Get
Yes!
Up.
Yes! What? What? I mean, y'all know that song?
I'm telling you, when you sent me your tracks, by the way, you know you sent me 27 tracks of Talkbox.
See what I mean, 27 dude? Tracks.
Because it's like layering background vocals and different sounds. So on the track, you hear 27 tracks of Talkbox.
Ooh.
When I put that into the track, my jaw hit the floor. I was like, what? It just blew me away. And I mean, wow. You set that track on fire. I'm telling you right now.
Thank you, man.
So how do people find you online? What's your go-to place?
My go-to is, you know, Instagram, Twitter, you know, Facebook,
okay.
TikTok now. We went viral on TikTok. It was all crazy. Right. And so now we're there. Let me see.
Is your MySpace. Handle Mr. Talkbox everywhere?
Everywhere, MySpace. Mr. Talkbox.
All right.
All the people that's back there on MySpace still, we good. We riding with you too.
Nice. Before I let you go, can we play a song together?
Absolutely. What song is that going to be, though?
Gee, I wonder. Thanks again, everybody. Mr. Talkbox, my man.
Thank you. Thank you, Brian.
We about to get real funky tonight. Yeah. Come on, play it cumbersome, baby. Come on, come on,
come on,
Mr. Talkbox. Come on, everybody. Ooh.
Mr. Talk Woo. Box, my man.
Thank you.
Wow, that was so much fun. Oh, my goodness. Mr. Talk Box, I can't thank you enough for being here tonight. Ah, that's unbelievable what you do. How do you do that? Let's talk. Ah, hey, you know what? We got to sing it out. Thank you guys for being here. Shout out to Marcus Anderson and Marcus's coffee. My man. Ah!
It's Friday night.
It's Friday night. That's right, it's Friday.
It's Friday night.
It's Friday night.
It's Friday night.
I didn't even get to drink my wine. What? All right, everybody. Hope you had a good time tonight. And now you know everything about the Talk Box. Guess what? Let me tell you about next week.
It's Friday night. It's Friday night.
Oh, I'm breaking it down next week. What?
It's Friday night. It's Friday night.
We're doing black and white night next week. You're like, what? What did you just say? We are doing black and white night. I am taking all the color out of the screen. It's going to be film noir. That's what I mean. Next week is going to be real cool. We'll see you in the chat room in just a sec. Thanks, you guys. Later. Oh, my goodness. Well, there it was. Hey. Thank you, guys. That was fun tonight. Hope you learned some things, right? Yeah. Marcus Anderson popped in there. How'd he get in there? See, black and white edition. It's like we're gonna go back in time. We go back to the 30s when they invented the talk box. Oh yeah. Hey, go get playlist latest album, Mr. Talk Box. It is hot. I'm telling you, it's hot. You heard two tracks tonight, so you gotta go. Listen to it. Get your hot tracks on. Yeah. Oh, man. It was fun. And this, now I'm going to drink the wine. You see? Man, Byron, I'm telling you, you got to get some of this. If you like Moscato, you're going to love this. Sparkling sweet wine. Oh, man, it's so good. All right. The castle. Anyway, okay. Who all is in the chat? What's going on here? Hi, Rhonda, Kilpatrick, and Linda Boney. Hey, you guys. Yeah, thanks for hanging out. Brian McLaughlin, black and white. Cool. When the contrasts are paid attention to. Yes, you know what I'm talking about. We'll see how it goes. I don't know. We just take the saturation down to zero. Marcus Howery, yes. Did you stay with it? Yeah. I tried. I had a few moments. It's all good. Hey, it's live television. We are live. Did you know we're live? It's all good. Have a great week, you guys. It's January. It's cold. But hey, you know, it's all good. Yeah. Darlene's going to have a white party at your house next Friday. See, that's a cool idea. Let's just do that. Everybody have a white party next Friday night for the black and white edition. Yeah. And it's going to be great. I'm not wearing red. Although I could wear red and you wouldn't know it. I guess we'll see what happens, eh? Yeah. I love this hat, by the way. Mr. Talkbox World Tour. And If the world tour gets back up on YouTube, I'll let everybody know about it. Because you got to see it. It's an awesome show. Hopefully it'll get back up there. I'll keep you posted. Cheers, everybody. Shout out Mr. Talkbox. Catch y'all later. I'm going to go paint. And drink. Later.